Hey, Brookwood, welcome to Bible Party Online. It is the night before Thanksgiving. So I hope you have a happy Thanksgiving tomorrow. But tonight, we are going to have a little bit of fun right before we celebrate that awesome holiday. And we're going to begin with a little Name That Tune. And this is going to be an international edition of Name That Tune. Songs by people who are from different countries than the United States. So these are also songs that are in English, I should say. Well, with the exception of one. One's not in English, but I still think some of you will know these songs. They're well-known songs. So here's our international version of Name That Tune. Let's see if you can name the tune of this first song.
If you change your mind, take a chance. I'm the first in line. Honey, I'm still free. Take a chance on me. If you need me, let me know. Gonna be around. If you got no place to go, when you're feeling down. If you're all alone.
That was Take a Chance on Me by ABBA. ABBA is a group from Sweden, and that song is called Take a Chance on Me. The second song is a well-known song, and most of you, if not all of you, will know the band. But let's see if you can name the song.
Hey Jude, don't make it bad. Take a sad song and make it better. Remember to let her into your heart. Then you can start to make it better. Hey Jude, don't be afraid. Made to go out and get her. The minute you let her under your skin, then you begin to make it better.
All right, that was Hey Jude by the Beatles. The Beatles and Hey Jude. And our final song is, I guess it's kind of considered a Christmas song, but it's sung outside of Christmas season as well. It's one of my favorite songs. It's in Italian. Let's see if you can name this tune. That was Ave Maria. Ave Maria. Beautiful song. All right, that's our Name That Tune international version. You made it through. And I would like now to pray, and then we will dive into God's Word this evening before we finish out with a little dance party. But would you pray with me to kick this time off? Lord, thank you for your goodness and your mercy. And we want to give thanksgiving to you this week, this Thanksgiving week. We are thankful to you for your Son his death on the cross and his resurrection. We are thankful to you for Brookwood. We are thankful to you for good food and friends and family. And we thank you for your many blessings upon us. We ask that you would speak to us now through your word. In your precious name we pray. Amen. Amen. All right, y'all. Well, we are officially finishing our series tonight on how God uses people with problems. We've been talking about that for some time now, that God uses people with problems. And we've looked at people throughout the Bible who have problems. They have issues. They have bad character. Or maybe they're facing a really difficult challenge. Or maybe they're really sick. Or maybe they're injured or whatever. Or maybe they make a huge mistake. Whatever the case, all these people throughout the Bible that God uses in amazing ways, they had problems. You think about King David. He did really bad things. He had problems. You think about Moses. He had doubts about God. He had problems. You think about Peter and Paul. Peter denied Jesus. Paul, we're going to talk about today. All these folks have problems. And so it's encouraging to me, because seeing how God uses people with problems throughout the Bible, I realize, you know, I have problems. But God can still use me. He uses people with problems. Now, we've reached the end of this series. We've talked about all these different problems that people have had throughout the Bible, but God still used them. But tonight, we're talking about the ultimate problem you can have. And we're going to see if God can use people with this ultimate problem. Now, I don't know if you, I've talked about Star Wars before, I know. I don't know if you are a Star Wars fan if you're watching this, but regardless whether you are or are not, you've probably heard of Darth Vader. I don't know. You've probably heard of Darth Vader. Darth Vader was the bad guy in the original Star Wars movies. He was really scary and intimidating. And Luke Skywalker was the good guy, right? And Luke Skywalker, throughout those movies, went through all kinds of adventures and all these dangers, and he fought stormtroopers, and he encountered monsters, and he had to survive being captured, and he had to do all of these things, and he gets through all of these obstacles, and at the end of the series, he has to confront the biggest obstacle of them all, Darth Vader himself. And it's similar to what we're talking about today. We've talked about all these problems, but today we talk about the ultimate biggest problem you could have. Will we be able to overcome it? Can God still use us in spite of it? And here's what we're going to conclude with. It's that God can use you even if you are God's enemy. Wow, God can use you even if you are God's enemy. That is the ultimate problem you could have with God, isn't it? If you're his enemy. You don't just fail here and make a mistake there or have an illness here. You're literally God's enemy. And even if you're God's enemy, could God use you? Well, I think we're going to see. Yes, he can. So we're going to see in Acts chapter 9, I need to get there, that Paul, the apostle Paul, was God's enemy. He did not like God's people. He was trying to harm Christians. He hated them. He was God's enemy. But we know the Apostle Paul ends up being this amazing Christian leader. So God uses him. But let's see what this story says. In Acts chapter 9, it says, Paul was still breathing out murderous threats against the Lord's disciples. That just sounds scary, doesn't it? He was breathing out murderous threats. Sounds like a villain. He was not happy with Christians. He was trying to kill people who were part of the church. He was God's enemy. But what happens? Jesus appears to Paul in this chapter. It says, as Paul neared Damascus on his journey, suddenly a light from heaven flashed around him. He fell to the ground and heard a voice say to him, Paul, Paul, why do you persecute me? Who are you, Lord? Paul asked. Who's this voice speaking to me? The voice said, I am Jesus, whom you are persecuting. Now get up and go into the city, and you will be told what you must do. Jesus says, Paul, you are persecuting me, and I'm going to now take control of your life, and you're going to obey me. So when I was a kid, you know, I had a brother, a younger brother, who's 2 years younger than I did, and we would horseplay. We would get into wrestling matches, we'd knock things over sometimes, and we would, you know, be a little rough. And it was all fun and games until we did something that made our dad upset. And he would get really serious and he would say, stop that right now. And we would stop. We didn't want to get in trouble. And this is kind of what's going on with Paul. Paul is going around. He's trying to imprison Christians. He's helping to execute Christians. It's not good at all. He's doing all these things, and Jesus shows up and he says, Paul, stop that. And Paul, we find out, he does obey what Jesus tells him to do, and he does end up getting baptized and becoming a follower of Jesus, and he ends up writing half the New Testament almost, and planting churches and being a missionary, and he does all these amazing things. But he was God's enemy. And God used him. Now, you're like, Anthony, I'm not God's enemy. Paul might have been, but I'm not God's enemy. Well, no, you're not an enemy of God like Paul was. But apart from Christ, we all kind of are enemies of God. When we disobey God, when we refuse to listen to him, when we hear God tell us to go right and we go left, we're acting like enemies of God. We're resisting what he's trying to do in our lives and in the world. And we act like enemies of God. But when we put our faith in Christ, like Paul did, when we repent of the things we've done in the past, when we trust him and follow him and obey him, well, then God can turn that around like nothing. And God can use you even if you are an enemy of God. So no, we're not God's enemies, but apart from Christ, before we knew him, we were. But through faith in him, God turns us around, gives us grace, and he helps us to do his will. God can use you even if you are God's enemy. God uses people with problems, y'all. All right, we need to write a card. And I thought it would be appropriate. Obviously, I'm not going to physically deliver this, but I thought it would be appropriate. We could write a card to Jesus. Now, like I said, we're not going to physically, there's nowhere to physically bring it to Jesus, but we can write it as a prayer to him, and he'll hear it. We don't have to deliver it because he can hear us, right? So let's write this card. And we'll write it kind of as a prayer. So here's what we could say. Dear Jesus, thank you for dying on the cross for our sins. Thank you for rising from the dead. We praise you. You are good and you are awesome. We've been talking at the Brookwood community lately about how you use people with problems and how you can use us even if we are your enemy. We praise you for that. We thank you for your good news that we can be forgiven of our sin, we can be made righteous, and have your Holy Spirit when we put our faith in you. Your friends, the Brookwood citizens. What do you think? Different kind of prayer, right? All right, well, that's our card to Jesus. And I know he received that, and I bet he really appreciated it. So, let's dance. It's time to celebrate. And there's a lot of reasons to celebrate right now. We finished a series. Tomorrow is Thanksgiving, for goodness sake. So let's celebrate God and his goodness with this song.
The lost are returning home. There will be singing, there will be dancing. Jesus, our hope is here. The sound of the hurting will turn to rejoicing on that day. I know that you're coming.
Let peace fill the streets, let justice release every
right, everybody. Thank you for joining me tonight. I hope you have a happy Thanksgiving, celebrating with others. And for now, let's close in prayer. God, you are good. And we praise you that you use people with problems. We thank you that we don't have to be perfect for you to use us for your glory. We can just put our faith in you and trust in you and obey you. And you can use us. We thank you for your son. And we thank you for Thanksgiving. We pray you would bless our celebrations tomorrow. Amen. There we have it, folks. Y'all have a great Thanksgiving. I will see you later.